So, you know, there's this famous birthday paradox.
Yeah.
Yeah, it says that I think if you have some very small number of people, maybe like 25 or something, then there is a better than 50% chance that two people have the same month and day of birth. It's very surprising because there are 365 days in a year. But even with a group,
if you have a class of 25 or something, or 23, 24 something.
Yeah, some small number, you can actually.
Then they will be, there's a high probability, more than 50% probability, that two of them will have the same
birthday.
This has 30 cards.
So let's check whether it happens or not.
So two how people, whether we want to check whether two
people have the same
birthday.
Birth date in terms
of birthday in the sense of
whatever we have here, which is the month and date.
Month and date.
So shall we try that? So now we have to first.
I don't believe it.
It seems unbelievable because there are 365 different days possible, or 366.
And you only need to pick two, no?
Yeah, and it's very remarkable that this might happen with such a small group. So let's see. So what we have to do is now check for, say, the first card, Abhirami.
So how do you do it? I mean, so
we have,
we go through, iterate. As usual, we'll iterate, go through.
So for every card.
So Abhirami has 9th October.
So we have to check whether anybody
9th
else
October
has.
Or somebody else has got.
9th October. Right, and then we have to do it for the next person and so
on.
So we,
I take Abhirami and I have seen Abhirami.
Yes.
So I put it in the second list.
And
but
now
with Abhirami, I have to do something else.
Now we have to look at everybody else and see if anyone else is 9th October. Otherwise, we know that Abhirami is not one of them.
Okay. So which means you go through this list.
Yes.
The list which you have not seen actually.
Yeah. So we have not seen these yet, but we want to check them with Abhirami first. And then we will check them on their own.
Okay. Let's check. 9th October we have picked.
Yeah.
So one by one. So again, so I keep it here. This is the first
card. The first card that we are checking.
Okay.
This is
the first card that we are checking, the second iteration. Not second actually, right?
This is an iteration within
an iteration. Within that iteration.
So for every card.
We have actually.
Yeah. So for every student, we have to check every. Yeah. For every student. We have to check every other student.
So we have an outer iteration, which is this Abhirami we have started with.
Yeah.
And now we are starting a
inner iteration.
Inner iteration inside.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah.
So okay. Against Abhirami, now we are checking. So again, this iteration also we will do the same thing. We'll move to another pile.
Correct.
So Deepika moves to the second pile.
Yeah. So this is not there.
Not the case.
This is not the case. 30th. We are looking for 9th October. So 30th December, 13th October. So the month is the same but not the day.
Okay.
26th December, 15th March, 14th December, 4th March, 6th December, 23rd, 10th September.
Okay.
22nd, 3rd June, 22nd July, 17th July, 23rd July.
Okay.
17th November. So we just keep checking, and if we see the same date, we will stop.
You're done. You're done actually.
But right now, so far we have not done that. So we keep going until we run out of cards. We finish the iteration.
Okay.
And in this case, we finish the iteration, and though we found an October, we didn't find.
So 9th October is not a date where there are two people with the same birthday.
Correct.
But that doesn't mean that they
could not. Yeah, because they could be within this. They could be two different.
So what do I do now? So in the first, the outer iteration, I started the outer iteration, picked out Abhirami.
So we know that Abhirami.
And then I went through an inner iteration where I looked at all the other cards.
Yes.
Right. So I'm done with looking at all the other cards. Now what do I do now?
Now we have to do this, say for example, for Akshaya. But
so I have to take the outer iteration now moves to the next
correct,
card.
Correct. And we have to keep track that we have already seen Abhirami in the outer iteration. So maybe we should create a second stack like this, maybe.
Oh. So because for Akshaya, you have to compare Abhirami again.
Yeah, for Akshaya, we'll have to compare these cards and those cards. Because we'll have to compare Akshaya with every card.
Every card. Okay, so we take out Akshaya. Yeah. Now this is outer iteration.
Outer iteration.
All right. Now, so for Akshaya, now I have to compare
first that one.
Okay, it's not. All right.
Okay, so we'll move it there just to say that we have done. So we have finished the iteration of those guys.
Okay.
Now we have two iterations of
these
guys.
Ones. All
so right. We are looking for 8th February.
Yeah.
So this is 28th February, which is close but not good.
Okay.
5th May, 6th May, 16th May, 15th March, 17th September, 14th January, 4th January, 12th, 30th. So if we don't see February, we can quickly go through them.
Yeah. July. So this is going to take long time, huh?
Yeah.
Because for every card, we are checking every other card.
Correct.
So that is like 30 cards. And then another 30 cards. So
900 cards. 900 times we are doing this. Yes.
Oh my God.
So this is going to take a long time. But Okay. So now okay, we have said Akshaya doesn't have this. So Akshaya moves into the pile with Abhirami saying outer iteration is done.
But here.
But done.
We have to start again. Yeah. Right?
Now we start again with the next card here, which is Deepika. So now we are checking for 13th of May.
13th May.
So then we will say that first we will go through this. So Akshaya is not there. Abhirami is not there.
All right.
Okay. Then, and then we have to go through this. So again we are looking
okay,
for
May. So we are taking one card, checking that card against all those that we have seen, and then all those against we have not seen.
Yeah.
Right?
And then finally, if we finish, then we mark this as seen.
And
so that
yeah,
we don't
mark this as seen and you finish. All right. I get
so
it.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So 13th May.
Yeah. No luck so far. So maybe this thing is wrong. Huh? Maybe what they say about these 25 people having the same birthday.
A lot of Mays, by the way. I noticed a lot of Mays, but
yeah,
still we are
not hitting.
Yeah.
Bad luck. Okay. So now we can move Deepika to that.
So Deepika, and then you go like this. Huh?
Yeah.
Okay.
So now
this
we again.
This is the pile that we have seen. This is the pile we have not seen.
Yeah.
Okay.
So again we could Surya here.
Surya. Now so again you have to check with the pile you have seen.
Yeah. Yeah. So 1, 2, and 3.
Okay. Now. Okay. Now you check with the pile we have not seen.
5 February, right? So I don't even see a February coming.
So this. This nested iteration, one iteration within iteration, creates so many.
Yeah, it takes a lot of time. So that's something that we have to try and avoid
careful,
if we can. Yeah, if we have, can avoid it, we should.
Can we avoid this? Does it look like we can avoid this, right?
Yeah,
how do you avoid?
Yeah.
Okay.
Bad luck.
So no. So again, back. Go here.
Yeah.
30th August.
Okay, but I can see one thing which we can reduce.
Mm-hmm.
See, these guys, we have already checked against everybody, right? Because we have been through a full iteration for all of them.
Yeah.
So, in particular, we know that this does not match any
so
of these.
So, we have compared 28th February against all the cards.
All the cards here.
So,
and
when you take a card from here and compare it to 28th February, you are repeating
exactly,
the check again.
Exactly. So, when we do these new cards, we do not have to go back to
because
those.
A equal to B and B equal to A is the same check.
Correct.
Isn't
right.
it?
So at least we can save looking at
so
those.
So we don't we need to look at this. Oh.
So each nested iteration will at
okay.
least become
so
smaller.
So that's something.
Yeah. So let's
so
try
it'll
that.
Get smaller each time.
Yeah, it will get smaller each time.
So instead of doing 30 into 30, now you are doing first time you did 30, next you will do 29.
Yeah, so a little bit of
28.
Yeah, a little bit of saving.
27 and as we go further, it will become much faster, no?
Yeah, hopefully.
So hopefully. All right. This
little
sounds
bit
good.
Of saving, yeah. So now 30th August, December, October, December, March, December, March, December, March, September, September, June, July, 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 November, not even seeing August, April, January, 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 September.
So it's probably not true here.
March, May, May, May.
So no August.
Yeah.
Okay. So this is done.
But now the good thing is that those guys
those
we never have to we never
no.
have to look at them. So now we have
5th of May.
Very close, 6th of May, 16th of May, 15th of March, 17th of September, April, November, July, June, September.
So it doesn't look like
March.
The order matters, no? Because we are shuffling it as we go along, we are shuffling the whole thing.
Yeah.
Doesn't matter, right?
Doesn't matter because we are just looking for two which are equal at this point.
Mm. So this guy is gone.
Yes.
All right.
So now we have December. Hmm. October 26th, December.
Oh, okay.
March, December,
okay, December.
14th.
Chance.
March
yeah.
6th.
Chance, yeah.
So a lot of Decembers, but nothing
indicate,
is close.
Yeah.
September, June, July, hmm. November, April, January.
A lot of Januarys.
January, September, March, May.
May also, a lot
May.
Of Mays. Okay.
That's gone.
Okay. Maybe you have luck now. 6th May. Maybe 6th May is our lucky guy.
16th. 15th March, September, January, April, November, July.
July also lots,
sir. September. March, December. October.
No luck. Okay.
October 13th. December, March, September, June, July, 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 November, November, April, January, 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 September, March, May.
Okay, that's good. So this is why I think, you know, when we do these algorithms, when we try to develop programs, we got to think through how we are doing it, right? Because this business of
Just blindly doing something which may be correct, I mean it is correct, but if we don't think about
wasteful, right?
Think about what we are doing,
I think better and better ways of doing these things.
Okay, so May, March, so we are looking for 16th May.
16th
May. March, September, January, 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 April, November, November, July, 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 June, September, September, March, December, March, December, March, December.
Okay, it's gone.
It's gone.
So we are kind of halfway through, I think. I hope it goes faster now.
December, March, December, but bad luck. March, again December, no. March, September, September. At least each round is becoming a little shorter.
Yeah.
June,
yeah, exactly.
July, 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 November, November, April, January, 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 September, March.
Okay, no luck.
Okay, so now let's try 15th of March.
All right.
September, January, January, 12th, January, April, November, November, July, 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 June, September, September, March, no. 6th December, 4th March, no. 14th December.
Yes!
So we found a pair.
Wow!
So it's amazing. Wow. Huh? So it's actually true. I mean, at least what the probability tells us actually has come right in this case. So we did find a pair. But it took a lot of work.
So, okay. So,
and of course, there could be more pairs in this, but
More pairs.
But let's be happy that we have found one pair.
One pair. So, what did we do? I mean, let's just reflect what we did.
Yeah.
We said, okay, we have this is not possible to do without a loop within a loop, an iteration within an iteration, right?
Yeah. So, I don't think if we just have
because
these
you
cards.
Just do, because you have to compare everything with everything else.
Yes.
So, that means that if there are 30 cards, you have to compare 30 cards against 30 cards. Of course, we try to not
so
compare it twice.
Yes, we have compared one A with
B. If you have compared A with B, no need to compare B with A again.
Yes.
That way you can reduce a little bit, but still kind of you have to compare everything with everything, right?
Yes.
Now, but and if you have to compare everything with everything, you cannot do it with one iteration followed by another iteration like we did earlier.
Yes.
Because one iteration will do some 30
things.
Steps it will do, and then this iteration will do another 30 steps.
Correct.
Whereas if you are doing this into this,
yes,
30 into 30, you have to do 900.
Yeah.
Maybe you reduce it to half because you are.
Yeah, because each one you are counting this, it's
twice counted.
Yeah.
So 900 may become 450 or some, I don't know, some small, slightly smaller number, but it is still.
Yes. So you can't certainly do it in
you
two
cannot
or
do it in
a fixed number of iterations.
Can't do it. So it has to be one iteration inside. So we have now, till now we have not seen this, right? We have not seen this.
Yes.
Business of taking one iteration
fixing one thing and then comparing
putting another iteration.
Yeah,
so one iteration sitting inside another iteration. One, right? We have not seen this before. Now it's complicated because it seems that keep track of things. I mean, of course, it was small, so we were able to do it. But keeping track, when you do this inner iteration inside an outer iteration, keeping track becomes difficult because when you're doing the outer iteration, you have seen some cards. You have kept it in a different pile.
Yes.
And then you're going to see some cards. Now this inner iteration has to go through the whole thing again, which means it has to go
in
through
general,
the cards.
That's right.
If in this case, it turned out basically that we didn't have to. But you have to go through the cards that you have already seen, then you have to go through the cards you have not seen.
Correct. So I agree. It's a lot of this administration.
Administrative work.
Yes.
But so and if you had iteration within iteration within iteration, then.
Yeah. Yeah. For instance, that would be even harder, right?
Even more harder.
Yeah.
Right? And it will take a long time. Because you know this 30 into 30, 900 will be 30 into 30 into 30.
Correct.
9 into 30, which is like, you know,
2700.
Oh my God.
You'll have to 27,000.
Right? So we'll never be able to do it manually. We need a computer to do it, right?
Yeah.
So anyway, we saw an iteration within an iteration for the first time. Are there any other examples of this iteration with the iteration that we can think of? Where does it come? I mean, of course, dates. Common dates. When does it come and why do we get iteration within iteration?
Yeah, so whenever we have to do this kind of
pairwise
comparison, right? So you want to look at everybody, and so for instance, if we looked at our shopping bills, supposing we wanted to find out two customers who shop in the same shop, then we would again have to do this, right? We would have to
have both the customers gone to the same shop. If I have to find out, then first I have to take this customer, find the shop, find a bill, which shows whether
so
the customer
is more complicated.
Even more complicated. Then from that shop, I have to find. You want to try that? I mean, from that shop, find out whether there's another customer.
Yeah, maybe there's a better way to do that. Is there a better
two customers who shopped in the same shop?
So I think that there may be, in that case, a slight improvement we could do, which is to separate out the bills by shop, right? So we could have all the bills for one shop, all the bills for another shop, all the bills for a third shop. So we can first do this kind of, which we had done before, if
we had separated
by some category, like all the people who had got marks between 50 and 60 or something like that.
So in that case, you just have to count whether there is more than one person.
Then we have to look in each shop, we have to just look, do the same thing. But even within a shop, we have to do that iteration, but for a smaller group.
So it is one iteration following another iteration there.
No, it will be a first iteration to separate, but within each shop we have to do a nested iteration, right? We have to look for any two people in that.
Any two. You have to see whether there are two different names in that list.
Correct, at least two.
So that won't give you a nested iteration.
Yes.
It gives you only a So that's an easier problem.
Yeah, it's an easier problem.
In some sense the complexity of this problem, you know, so you can we're already seeing that the problems are falling into buckets, right? Some problems are looking like they are somewhat I'm just saying using the word easier.
In the sense that you can do them in one pass,
or even if you don't do it in one pass, you do one pass, maintain some values, and do one more pass, second pass, and you are able to solve the problem. There are some things like this. It didn't look like, I mean, finding two people who have the same date look, I mean, at first face looks like an easier problem to do than three prizes.
Correct.
Three prizes we did in one pass.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah, essentially, because one pass to find the top three, and then one pass to find subject-wise top three. So that's
two passes we did.
Yeah.
But here we have nested iteration.
Yeah.
So this looks like, while the problem looks simpler than that, that problem looked much more complex in terms of statement.
Yeah.
But to solve it was easier.
Yeah.
This problem, on the other hand,
is easy to state.
Easy to state.
But to do the actual
thing seemed very hard.
Yeah, so maybe we'll come back and see whether we can do something better with this or with other problems, and see what makes these problems require this kind of thing as we go along.
Okay.